Was there a guest this morning? If you have any other guests or are there guests being held, we can do so this time. Seeing none, Pastor, I have a free time.
I do. I'm asking Bob and Bob to come up here and talk for a minute this morning. As you know, we're doing our Rainier Stewardship Campaign. If you're visiting this morning or wherever you haven't heard what's going on, we're trying to raise $100,000. It's going to cost us over $60,000 to replace the roof, which is 50 years old. And we're trying to hopefully raise enough money to figure over $40,000 over 3 years. We could phase it in, get a grant from the Conference Hope for a Youth Pastor on staff. So we have an army of children who will be coming out and becoming youth here in the very near future. So we were up to $90,000 for Bob and Rob going to raise the roof here for this morning. That's going to help too. Just to make sure it's stable, because it's only designed and to go up to 100,000. And I've got good news to tell you. And to go to the very last poll, guys. So Bob takes off the total there on the top there, Bob. We've gone from 90,000 to 113,000. So, not only that, it was designed, that 5.5 was designed for me to be able to get underneath it when we reach that far. We now have to put a stool or a thing up inside, and I can still stay underneath it. Because we're at $113,000, so thank you so much for your generosity. It's tremendous. I thought $100,000 was daunting, and you come through tremendously. So we should be able to absolutely move forward with our plans, which we're just thrilled with, thrilled for everyone's response. Should more come in, all that means is we'll be able to phase in the youth pastor over more time into the general budget and make sure we can keep that position for a long time to come. So if you haven't yet made a contribution, please don't think, oh, they don't need my money. It'll just make it easier for us to be able to do that, so please. Also, we have received 106 of the 125 giving cards we're hoping for next year to help us with the grant process and to really know what our income will be next year in terms of the budget. So we're still looking for another 19. If you haven't put in the estimate of giving card yet, that'll help us reach the number we need to apply for the grants. So please consider doing that. The red and the yellow boxes have been placed out of the narthex where the sign is going to go this morning. I'll keep that in the narthex now. I don't know the way for the contrato this morning. So if you have like quick cards in the boxes out there, that's out of the narthex. This is going very, very well as well. And we're just thrilled and ecstatic, the leadership of the church of how you come through. Thank you very, very much. It's a wonderful thing to celebrate.
So the question in the hour is, how many men does it take to raise the roof? Flowers this morning are from Bert Morales and author of his poem. Coffee and tea will be available until you call after the worship. So,
what
I'm
looking
out
to, we put a white envelope inside the bulletin this morning, so you know what this is for. You heard me say on Christmas Eve, I heard you were on a white envelope. And what I say is to put Jesus on the envelope, put it on your Christmas tree. Ours is already on there. If the kids give something to God this year, they write it down and they stick it in the envelope and we open this up then on Christmas morning. What we wanted to do is give the congregation a chance during the cantata this morning to present some type of an offering to God as a Christmas gift. So what we're going to encourage you to do is to take this white envelope this morning. You see there's a song in the cantata which says, please bring your white envelope forward at this time. If you've already thought of something you've done for God this year, done for Jesus this year, you like to write it down in an envelope and bring it forward and place it up here in front of the room at that time. It's just an act of worship. You've got to bring a gift forward to God. Also, if you have something instead that would be a prayer request, something that you need from God or need from the church or need prayer for, you could write that down on here as well and bring it forward at that time to cantata. We just want to have a time of worship where we can offer up to God what we have or receive from God, offer up the prayers that we need for each other. And we're going to try to look through these and try to talk about the children and everything, what gifts are being given to God by the congregation this year, and then try to pray for those people who need prayer concerns. So that will happen during the cantata this morning. See the bulletin. We'll be doing City Fair solo. We'll be asking you to bring these forward this morning.
Please take this time to fill out the attendance and registration form and put it in the plate that I have this morning. Also, today is the last day of the voting status, if you have a copy of the voting, you can use it, but you have to have a plate that's on the slide also. The money gives you whatever you order, it's in the center. On the back of that, you'll see there's donated Bibles, we talked about that a little bit last week. If you're able to give a little bit of money, you can have a $10 Bible. If you're able to help, you can see the approval back there. Looks like the two for shut-ins is going to happen on Thursday, December 20th. If you're able to provide ingredients or help with that, that would be there. Junior church this morning is available only for the preschool or preschool this week. It will be back next week. And it's going to be your church at ages 3 through 5. There is a first week for it, there's one staff back there. Any other ones to think of? Seeing none, let's just take time to read each other this morning.
Thank you.
worthy of our praise. God, let us remember always that your grace is enough for us. Time in a world when children are being shy, we have no explanation. When people are lost and searching for you, may we remember when our hearts are troubled that your grace is enough. Your grace saves. Your grace brings eternal life. So, Lord, we thank you for that grace this morning as we worship you in this place. Fill our hearts, fill this place with your Spirit, that we might be drawn closer to you as we worship you today. In the name of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. You may be seated. This time, Father, speak to you, boy, we come forward to lay your life dead for us.
Okay?
there's a picture of Gabrielle again on this one. See that? She's about 3 here, it looks like. I'm being told she's older than that. So. There's the picture with the ornament, okay? Here's the ornament, and we hang all these on our tree. Here's one with a picture of my son Samuel on it. See that? That's one of my favorite Christmas presents. You could see it. Can you see it now? Here's one. Find another one of my son Christian. Here's a snowflake with a picture of my son Christian on it. I've got 4 kids, so I've got 4 winners to show you. Takes a little time, right? Can't leave anybody out. And here's one with Elizabeth. Elizabeth was just a baby. See, you're a baby there. See, there's Elizabeth's baby picture on an ornament. See? Everybody see? All right, now, these are some of my favorite Christmas presents ever. And none of them cost much money at all. Right? If you're asking for expensive gifts at Christmas, or thinking that people need expensive gifts at Christmas, these are some of my favorite ones of all time. Now, who can tell me why? Take a guess. Why are these some of my favorite Christmas presents ever?
Hello Kitty.
Hello Kitty? I don't think you got the question. These are some of my favorite Christmas presents ever. You got it. Because I care about my children so much, right? These are kind of capturing a moment in time from Christmases with these kids, right? What do you think?
Dreams.
Dreams. Yeah, you guys have to tell me some things you'd like for Christmas, I guess, right? Dreams and stuff. Yes. What do I think about is when you're thinking about what to give people for Christmas. We talk about what to give God for Christmas, right? When you're thinking about what to give people you love for Christmas, right? If your moms and dads and your grandparents and stuff like that, there's nothing like a homemade gift that you made yourself. Even if it's just a card with a picture that you draw, right? That's going to mean so much to them, right? Or a note that you can write inside or get someone to help you write inside, right? Something with a picture is always great, right? Anything like that that's from you and it's from your heart. Because you know what they really love at Christmas time, your moms and dads and your grandparents and everybody? They love you guys. They love you guys. So don't worry that you don't have much allowance money to buy a great present for somebody. Because the best presents don't really cost money. The best presents that your mom and dad, your grandparents, and everyone will love forever and ever are the ones that you make come from your hearts. And that doesn't cost money to do. Now here's the other thing. The best presents you're going to get aren't the ones that cost the most money. They're not the best video games, right? Or Hello Kitty stuff, or train stuff, or whatever kind of stuff you want, right? The best gifts are going to be the ones that are acts of love for all those people who love you. So remember that too, alright? Alright, let's say a little prayer together, everybody. Dear God, we thank you. We've been talking a lot about gifts at Christmas, and we thank you that the best gift ever at Christmas was your son, Jesus. He came down here to teach us how to live and how to love. And we just thank you that you sent him to earth. Help us to remember always to try to follow his example. And try to live and love the way that he did. And at Christmas time, may we give a present to him from our heart. When we think about presents for other people, may we think about how to give them love from our hearts as well. Help us not to be worried about money and expensive gifts at Christmas time, but worried about love and spreading your love for everyone to receive. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, bigger kids are going to stay and help us sing, right? So preschoolers are going to go back to children's church. I'm dismissing all the preschool kids. Go back to children's church. Bigger kids are going to stay and help us sing today.
Thank you.
song is one of the prayer, hearts of prayer. Why don't you sing along with those, because of Come On You Faithful. Words will be on the screen, and please join together with our praise.
Thank you. the hospital for a reason, I don't know though. He's paying for me because I don't know what's wrong with him. He had the same thing as my my grandma, she died from it, so.
The nurse at Hubbard Middle School, Stephanie Patrick, lost her 20-year-old son to in a car accident on Tuesday. So the calling officer is saying the funeral is tomorrow, so keep it waiting on one.
Sally Allen also asks to continue prayers for her sister Peggy. We remember Peggy had a lesion on her kidney. She's also having back surgery this week. And with everything else going on, she's a victim of identity theft. She has a lot of stress in her life playing back, so please keep praying for prayers. Kathy Kepner asks for prayers for Jacob Rao, the son of a former nurse at Flat Rock. He has stage 4 brain cancer. Susie Ross asks for prayers for her sister-in-law, Debbie Ross. She had two cancer 2 years ago, and now she has a severe burn. Keep her in prayers.
Yes, I have a young friend who's 22 years old. His platelets are very, very low, and it's in serious condition there at the Cleveland Clinic. Michael Macy, he's 22 years old. He came in for prayer, please.
My mom would like me to announce, she's not here this morning because she's not feeling well, but she's another great grandmother. My other niece had her baby on Thursday, so she's great grandma number 5 now.
Mary's cousin or whatever.
I asked to pray myself this morning, so if we could just take a moment and have a moment of silence together, if we could please. Just try to put together a little bit of meaning here this morning and just remember
microphones are so low, you can't hear nothing. He can't
hear nothing. Children and adults as well were lost in this recent event in Newtown. And in my Sunday school class this morning, we're going to be kind of talking about that, how we process their emotion about that and stuff this morning. Kind of tying into Christmas a little bit, believe it or not. So I'm going to ask you, before we pray, let's have a moment of silence together, and let's try to hold and close in our hearts all the victims and their families and what they must be going through right now. Let's take a minute of pray silently together, please. God, we hold all these people in our hearts this morning. We hold them before you. We thank you that you did send your son Jesus into this world to open a path to heaven for all of us. And Lord, at a time like this when the entire nation is grieving and people around the world grieving with us, Lord, the senseless loss of life, people are searching for answers. And they wonder at times like this where you are. I pray that all might see, Lord, that you are in the response of love that comes forth, the response of caring that comes forth. That you're present with them to sustain them and give them strength during this time. Just as you are with us every day to sustain us. Give us strength when we go through the trials of our life, when we lose loved ones, when our loved ones face illness, when we face struggles of all kind. You are there with us, giving us your sustaining strength and love and power. Lord, as you have been with us in the past, we thank you that you're with us now and that you'll be with these families now. And so we pray, Lord, for your Holy Spirit to fall upon them powerfully, fill them,
But you'll surround them with people who will show your great love and power to them. Help them to trust and turn to you, and not away from you during this difficult time. Lord God, you've heard the names of a lot of people in our congregation that have been mentioned this morning. So many who need your healing power, the strength and comfort of your Holy Spirit. And Lord, we lift each of them and their needs up to you as well. We pray for our troops who are serving abroad. Pray that you keep them safe. Remind them of our love for them and your love for them at this season of Christmas. And Father, we pray for ourselves. Because we know, Lord, that this world is not yet the place that you want to be. We do not fully love you and love each other with all our heart, soul, and mind and strength. And so, Lord, we pray for ourselves that we might all open up ourselves to you this Christmas. Allow you to be born in us all over again. To grow in our hearts and rule there as King. We pray that every day we might follow the example of Jesus Christ. So that we might grow in love and grace. That we might be a light to the world. A world which clearly needs your love and power. Use us this Christmas and always, Lord, to spread your love to the world that needs it. Once more, we pray for these victims. We pray for their families. We pray for all who mourn this day. We pray, Lord, that you would use us as instruments of your love and peace to try to change the world and the place you want it to be. These things we pray this morning in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, the one who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Said the great treasure is made of heart will be also the wish of God each time we offer our hearts.
Thank you. Thank you. an invitation to persecute me for my visions and predictions. But I do hear the voice of God in my dreams, in other ways. And God's voice was soon telling me to proclaim the coming of the Messiah. Prepare the way for our God. Lay straight in the wilderness a highway for our God. I did feel like your voice crying in the wilderness. Lay straight through the wilderness, the highway of our God. Yes, I did feel like a voice crying in the wilderness. And the world was wrapped in darkness. We were waiting for a Savior. Send his son to set us free. Some thought that meant that God would crush the Roman Empire to offer freedom. God had a different plan, a plan that would surprise everyone. And God's plan would be completed in the fullness of his time.
Thank you. I work hard every day. I'm a carpenter. And Mary had come to me and said that she had some news that was overwhelming. So later that afternoon, she told me she was with child. What? I couldn't believe it. And then she goes to say that an angel had come to her, and that the baby was the Messiah, and that she should call him Jesus. This was unbelievable. I was so angry and mad. Without even thinking, I told her, we need to dissolve this engagement, and I would put her away somewhere safe. And just as I was about to call her to my plans, an angel had come to me and said that everything that Mary said was true. I was so excited and humbled. I mean, to think that God in heaven had chosen my Mary and me to raise the Messiah.
Thank you. pomp or pretension. He quietly came to us in a humble manger, clothed in flesh and bone.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to be registered with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child.
And he came to us. The Son of God was born to set his people free. Christ's coming was first announced to a group of shepherds in a lonely field outside Bethlehem. The celebration in heaven rang out in a glorious chorus of praise. Christ is born, and heaven and earth resound with joy.
Thank you.
but it ended up as a dream. Oh, I'm Shepard, by the way. We were out there protecting the lambs, and in the middle of the night, all of a sudden the night became bright as day. We all stood up to protect the lambs, but as soon as we stood up, we knew that whatever it was bigger than all of us. We started hearing these sounds like thunder and singing and symbols of celebration, and then we realized that they were angels proclaiming good news of the Savior. So we ran to this manger, and then amongst the animals, we saw a mother, a father, and a baby. It was a little hard to believe that this baby was going to free all of us, but we felt this peace that night. We all did. And not only did we feel that peace, but we also got to feel a touch of a joy.
Thank you, Lord, for the grace you bring to our minds, for the love you bring to our hearts. We worship you in spirit and in truth.
Jesus Christ, the King.
salvation. Jesus, our Lord, has come to live in our hearts.
Sing aloud. Behold his glory.
In that quiet nativity, Christ was born. Soon, astrologers who study the skies would follow a star and find Jesus to offer their gifts. In our busy celebrations of Christmas today, how do we worship Christ? What offerings do we give?
Where is the manger in our lives, and how can we find it? If we will seek him, we will find him. In the rush of our busy world, Jesus is ready to meet us where he offers his peace.
Thank you. trumpets sound, with harp and lyre. Praise him with timbrel and dancing, with stringed instruments and pipe.
Praise him with loudly sounding cymbals, with bells and with singing. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
The old and the young, let everyone praise the Lord. Praise God for the gift of his Son.
He has given us a gift, the gift of his only Son. Will you let him enter your life?
Will you let him enter your heart?
Thank you. Are you going to see it for a minute? I'm going to stand up here in a minute.
Since we're all clapping this morning, I thought it'd be inappropriate, morning of Christmas time, the second, the place of school and everything, to thank some people on our staff. And I want to begin with Nancy and Chris, who are with the video, down not only down from Todd, but always. So that's Nancy, want to stand back up again.
Thank you.
Christmas time as joyful as can be hard for so many. His forms are bending low, toil along the climbing wave, painful steps and slow. Look now, the glad and golden hours swiftly on the way. Rest beside the weary road. Hear the angels sing. Let us be those angels. For some who need to hear the good news, the love of God, the love of Christmas. Because some are crushed beneath life's load. Let us be the angels. Sing that song in whatever way that you can. Spread the love of God as Christmas and always. And as you do so with your lives, may the blessings of God the Father Almighty, Jesus Christ, His Son, our Lord and Savior, and the peace and unity of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore.